it's immediately obvious in New Hampshire how much support Ron Paul has. Now, before the snowstorms came, we had just a couple of days to stock the cabin, make sure we had enough food and supplies and material, and we needed to go get some signs from the headquarters. So we went by there, got our first batch of signs. We would go several times to keep resupplied. Then our primary objective was to make sure that every community with over 5,000 people in it had their main street flyered to death. We made sure that every single business got a packet from Ron Paul that had all the information that they needed to make the rational and logical and emotional decision in support of freedom. Well, these people are the ones that are the most active in their communities. They belong to a lot of civic organizations. They go to church. They see all the customers. These are regional shopping centers for all the people that live around the rural areas. And they come into contact with more people than anyone else, and we wanted to make sure that they were fully supplied with the information for themselves and to be able to share. Now, we would go back to the cabin and prepare the next day's packets and watch movies and fellowship and have a good time with each other. And then we took this packet, which was the holiday version of the love card. On the back, it would have all the information that you're familiar with about Ron Paul. We had a flyer that was full color that had an open letter from the founders in support of the Ron Paul Revolution. And we would have a flyer that was targeted for small business. When we also had Ron Paul's schedule, we would print those up in the communities that he would be appearing. We would make sure that they would get that information too. We get up in the morning, we make breakfast. We go outside, get all the snow off the cars, do some shoveling, and prep the automobiles, and we'd split up into teams, and we would go. But it snowed, and it snowed, and it snowed.
Family, I'm in the snow country.
Well, it was fun for us, but it made slowing go. But in a week and a half, we were able to hit every community with 5,000 people or more. We were very happy with ourselves, and we took our free time after that to make sure, while no one else is going out in the snow, that we did. Blue on white, very obvious, no chain link was safe. And we found other creative places to put them, including the airport. Now, the love cards we put at the large parking lots, we would go there and put them all over the cars. It was very impressive to come out and see an entire parking lot with the word love. We would also share it with the other campaigns. They were often had offices downtown, and we'd just go in and share the love.
Something's going on.
Well, that's good. I'm glad we stopped by here today.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you,
Brock, Travis. We came to Lebanon, New Hampshire today, not realizing that John Edwards was going to be in town. So we're in enemy territory, and these babies are going on all the car windows. Show them how many cars are around here, Brock. Everywhere.
Making sure that Ron Paul has a prominent presence at other campaign events is mainly benefited by having the media there. While the other campaigns are constantly being followed, oftentimes Ron Paul isn't. So by making sure that our material is all around, the media can't help but notice that the revolution's in town and Ryan isn't shy. So he just goes right up and talks to him. Well, we also find the other people's stuff that we help get back up. You know, this is a pleasant surprise. And then after the Glenn Beck interview, where he's threatening to French kiss Ron Paul, we went out and celebrated with some fireworks. Now, they told us that they were quiet.
Yeah.
They weren't.
You know, I think we're done.
So, it's all for my daughter. She's 5 years old. What else can I do? Gotta help somehow.
How many folks do you think you hit today?
Oh, over 1,000. We hit cars in 3 pretty large parking lots. Had to be over 1,000 cars. Plus the businesses.
I'm just here to spread the word about Ron Paul in New Hampshire.
So what does that mean?
That means, well, basically, I just want everyone to know about him. I want everyone to know what he's actually saying, you know, and what his views actually are. Because I think when people hear that, they're going to listen. They're going to realize that that's what we need for America.
Mike did a great job for the revolution in New Hampshire. While he was there, his car engine would seize. He'd have to junk it. And then he learned that his paternal grandfather had died. So we took him to the airport, where he went to New York to be with his family.
Travis, you looking forward to seeing Dr. Paul today?
Oh, yeah. I can't wait. I'm excited.
Get enough snow for a Phoenix boy?
Oh, yeah. I love it. It's beautiful. I could actually live out here. I wouldn't mind it. For a while.
Hi, Nice to meet you. All the way from Phoenix, from ASU. Oh, this is the house came and paid for you. You cured both of my parents out. I told her I was gonna do New Hampshire for you. Great, thank you. So you just like snowy weather. I do. You too. I could see his face glowing. That was a beautiful thing.
As soon as he said hello, I was like, what do I say? It was cool.
It was truly like Christmas for Travis and Ryan. They were having a good time, and the older ones of us were really enjoying their enthusiasm. Now, Ryan, he's the man. This guy, he is one of the best canvassers I've ever seen. Works without a script, knows what to say, and given the opportunity of miles of parked cars and nothing else to do, he took advantage of it.
Yeah.
Want to say something?
Stars. Who else promotes a presidential candidate on the freeway? Yeah, he's from Arizona. I'm from Iowa. We've got people from Vegas. Rhode Island? Missouri? What part of Missouri? Columbia. I've been there. I used to live in St. Louis for a little bit, so I know about Missouri. Yep. Well, I'm going to get some work done. It's nice meeting you guys. Thank you.
Now, all of us did our share of putting up signs, but Ryan and Travis, they went above and beyond the call. They made sure that we got great placement all over the place. But it wasn't all work.
We're about to conquer Mount Everest. We're about to go where no man has gone before. We don't do it because it's easy. We do it because it's hard. One small step for man, one giant leap for Ron Paul. Let's do it!
We got our mission accomplished, but we had fun doing it. We made sure that we got to meet a lot of people, we got to know each other better, and we made new friends. We had fun. We made sure that we took time out to enjoy ourselves so that it wasn't drudgery. We gave ourselves enough time to relax and to make sure that we were productive during the day. We accomplished a great deal, and we're looking forward to you joining us back in New Hampshire on the 28th through January 9th to help us spread the love and enjoy the winter weather. Since we've no place to go.